Marcus Conte reporting. How's everybody doing? You guys doing okay? So I'm here in the park. So let's talk about it. It's at the time of our choosing. What am I talking about? We say we want a revolution. Well, you know. Right? So let's talk about it. Right? So demilitarize, defund, America first. Everything I'm saying, everything I'm reading is in the comments down below. You can read it for yourself. Do your research, do your homework, contribute to this very simple plan. Because we can postulate and formulate this wonderful, very complicated theory on, you know, propose a new economic theory for America, right? But the fact is, it's rather simple. Less is more, right? Least resistance, less, right? So the average person can understand, take away the guns from the military, right? And de-arm police and such, and arm yourself, right? Easy, right? It's understandable. We have to cater to their better angels, the people carrying the weaponry that would ultimately be used against us in martial law. The other thing is easy. Defund. Just stay at home. Everybody understands that. What do I gotta do? Stay at home. Burn your bills. Have a fire. Huh? Mortgages, rent bills, all that shit. Throw it in the garbage. We'll start it over. Credit. Zip. Delete it. Huh? You can piss off a lot of people, right? Damn right. And America first. American citizens first. Sorry, guys. But this is what we got to do, right? 300 million people stand up. Holy shit. Is it possible? Do we freeze? Do we take your money out of your bank? Out of the bank, too. Take what you can. Leave the rest. 5% withdrawal on liquidity in the banks freezes the banks. Everybody runs to the bank, it freezes, right? So don't worry about that. Don't worry about anything, man. You guys are so worried. Oh, woo! Can't fire everybody. You can't sue everybody. And you can't jail everybody. Right? Because we're the everybody. We what are we going to do? That's the point. Okay? You stay at home 3 days, 5 days, a week. Whatever it takes. Bundle up. So I want to read in. Did I invent this? It's not passive resistance, but I'll read a word in. Satyagraha. Satyagraha. What the fuck does that mean, right? It's Sanskrit. Truth. Insistence. Wow. Fucking, you mean Gandhi had that shit figured out? They already have a word for it? Insisting on the truth? Oh, Conte, you're making that shit up. Let me read. So, someone who practices satyagraha is a satyagrahi. We'll scratch all that. We'll come up with a name. Right? Someone who, so satyagraha means truth, and graha is insistence. That's all it is, right? Again, read it down below. So the term was coined by Mahatma Gandhi. He developed the term during the Indian independence movement, where the British were basically told, your lease is up, it's time for you to go. And how exactly did they do it? In the way that I just described to you. They used something called passive resistance. We have to tweak that a little bit. Passive resistance, satyagraha, right? If I'm in the high weeds, let me know. It's very serious. I mean, it's also fun too, right? Right? We have to be one part Gandhi and the other part Sparta, right? In spreading this message, right? The time is now. You know? You just sit around waiting for no fucking cue and no politicians and no nobody. It's us, right? We are what we've been waiting for. Listen to this. If untruth does not so much as exist, its victory is out of the question. Isn't that brilliant? And truth, being that which it is, can never be destroyed. This is the doctrine of satyagraha, in a nutshell. This is what we're talking about. This is what we've always been talking about, a truth movement, right? You mean Gandhi already did it, right? The shit, they already proved it works. Does it work? When 9 out of 10 people say so, it works. Of course it works. What's it going to look like? Well, we'll talk about that later. This is interesting too. Gandhi said, I try to keep it short. I have also called it love force or soul force. In the application of satyagraha, I discovered in the earlier stages that pursuit of truth did not admit of violence being inflicted on one's opponent, but that he must be weaned from error by patience and compassion. For what appears to be truth to one may appear to be error to the other. It's important what he's saying. And patience means self-suffering. So the doctrine came to mean vindication of truth, not by inflicting suffering on your opponent, but on oneself. All right. I'll finish up with this. This is a lot. Satyagraha's object is to convert, not to coerce the wrongdoer. Right? The opponent must be converted, at least as far as to stop obstructing the just end, for his cooperation to take place. There are cases, to be sure, when an opponent, a dictator, has to be unseated, and one cannot wait to convert. Satyagraha would count this as a partial success. So again, what we're talking about is a total, in American lingo, colloquial, is a boycott of all goods and services. At the time of our choosing, we pick a time, we pick a day. Could be Christmas. And we look out our windows and everything is still. Everything has come to a screeching halt. Right? Easy. Not complicated. Not a very sophisticated plan. Do nothing. Right? And what do we want? We want taxation with representation. Right? If tax at all, we want our corporations to pay 80 or 90% tax and get us out of this mess. The other thing is, look, if you think billionaires are going to hold their ground, you're wrong, right? A billionaire who gives up 90% has no other choice but to relinquish 90% of his treasure. A billionaire, one billionaire, would still have $100 million. Now think about that. He's a millionaire 100 times over. Still. If he's allowed to keep 10% of his wealth. Corporations too. It's not a radical idea to arm oneself, to protect one's land. All right? I welcome your comments. Marcus Conte reporting.